Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today's a pretty exciting day for me personally because I get to introduce a little project I've been working on for the past 4 years of my life. And that is a John Wick tribute compensator that I like to call the Wicked Compensator.
This is the Wicked Compensator. This is a reimagining of the John Wick compensator on the original P30L that he used in John Wick 1. This is a functional thread-on compensator that is made of 7075 aluminum. It is bead blasted, so all the machine marks are completely off of it, just like it would be on the slide. And then it is type 3 hard coat anodized. It has individual serial numbers, so each one is unique and different, and requires a Heckler and Koch P30L SD threaded barrel.
Today, we're going to take my P30L. This is my LEM version that you guys have seen before in my Buy Once, Cry Once series on the Heckler and Koch long slide pistols. So we're going to take this P30L and we are going to convert it into a wick stick by adding a threaded barrel and a compensator. If you are one of the lucky recipients that happened to be on the pre-order list for the Wicked Compensator, this video will show you how to install the Wicked Compensator onto your P30L pistol should you decide not to take it to a certified HK armorer. Okay, I apologize for the background noise. My neighbors across the street are completely redoing their entire front yard and have a excavator going. When you get your Wicked Compensator kit, when you get everything out of the package, this is what will be coming in it. Now, if you have the collector's edition, you will have two additional items that standard edition kits will not have. And those items are as follows, just these two. The Dixon number 2 pencil, and the gold coin from the Continental Hotel. Only the collector's editions will have those particular items. Standard edition kits will have just these items. The Wicked Compensator kit, machined out of 7075 T6 aluminum with its individualized serial number. A recoil spring swap tool made out of Delrin. It's like a very hard plastic. A custom flat recoil spring made out of 302 stainless steel. A small vial of rock set, which I will not be using today because I have the big bottle of rock set. Then you will have a shim kit. The shim kit consists of 3 thick shims, 1 medium shim, and 1 thin shim. That is to clock the compensator to the slide. Now here are the items that you will need to provide in order to install this particular Wicked Compensator kit onto your Heckler & Koch P30L barrel. You obviously need a Heckler & Koch P30L in 9mm. Any variant will work. Doesn't matter if it's a V1, a V3, any P30L in 9mm will work. So you need your own P30L. You will need a factory HK P30L SD barrel. You'll see right here, barrel P30L SD 9mm. Part number on that is 229792. This is a 5-inch barrel from HK. You will need a set of soft jaw vices for your vise. You will also need an actual vise to do this in. The soft jaws are just so you don't damage or mar the actual compensator when you are holding it in the vise. A 5/8 inch wrench, because that is what is going to get onto the flat part of the barrel here so you can tighten this. A 16mm will also work, but a 5/8 has a better purchase with less wiggle room. So 5/8 or 16-inch open-ended wrench, and a set of pliers. Additionally, what I recommend, but is not required, it is up to you, a toothpick so that you can get the rock set out of your little vial here. And then a gallon Ziploc baggie so that while you are working on the recoil spring assembly itself and the removal of said recoil spring assembly, you can actually do it here inside of this bag so that when the spring releases and the washer flies, it will not fly across your garage and never to be seen again. It will actually be captured here within this Ziploc baggie. And what I would highly recommend doing before you do anything else is, one, double check that your handgun is unloaded, check inside the chamber, pinky it, check down the slide or the magwell, and check against the bolt face of the slide to make sure there's absolutely no ammunition in here. In fact, I would recommend not bringing any ammunition out to your workspace ever when you're doing gun projects like this. Highly recommend fully disassembling or at least field stripping the pistol and completely cleaning it, including cleaning the brand new barrel. Put an empty magazine in it and lock the slide to the rear. Then I want you to eject the magazine and put it aside. Now, if you've never taken down a P30L, this little notch right here needs to match this little notch here. And what we're going to do is I'm going to use my hand to slowly release it. And then with my other hand, I'm pushing on this little pin so that I can push this slide release lever all the way out. You'll notice there is a red band here at the top. Now the slide can actually come all the way off the front of the gun. I'm gonna take the frame, I'm gonna set that aside. So this is what you should be left with, a P30L slide assembly with a factory barrel and a factory recoil assembly. I'm going to take the factory recoil assembly out of the slide, and for now, I'm going to set that aside along with my baggie. Then I am going to remove the factory barrel. I'm going to set that aside. And I'm going to take my factory barrel and I'm going to install it into the slide. So what we need to do in order to install the Wicked Compensator onto the slide and barrel assembly is we need to stick the barrel out of the slide assembly pretty far. And what we're going to do with the Wicked Compensator is we're going to see where the threads on the Wicked Compensator and the barrel end up. So I'm going to thread it, and remember, left-hand thread, so you're going to be going the opposite direction that you are typically used to threading things on, forwards. I'm going to see that has now bottomed out. So now I'm going to let the slide or the barrel go into the lock block assembly. I'm going to see where that ends up. Not terribly far off, actually. It's just a little crooked. It's not quite at 12 o'clock, but our goal when we are shimming this is we want the ports, and this is going to be, again, if you're looking straight down the barrel, we want the ports and the center line of the ports of the Wicked Compensator to be at the 1 o'clock position in relation to the front sight post. The reason we want that is so we have enough tension when we shim it and rock set it in place to tighten it so that when it is tight, that 20 degrees has really locked it into place, and then we can match it up at the 12 o'clock position across the top. So in order to do that, I need to start my plans to shim it. Now this bottomed out just past what I would consider 11 o'clock, or just a little bit past 12. So I don't need a lot of shim to make this back at my 1 o'clock position. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the barrel and I'm going to remove the Wicked Compensator. And I'm gonna start with the smallest and the thinnest shim. You can tell that this is the smallest and the thinnest shim because it almost feels like paper. You can bend it really, really easily. It's just incredibly thin. It doesn't really feel like it's made out of metal. It feels like it's made out of some other material, but I assure you it's made out of very thin stainless. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna install that into the pocket here. And it's just going to seat at the very bottom of the compensator at the end of the threads. Now I'm going to re-thread it into position. And we're gonna see where it stops. And that's just about where we want it. So that would be when I'm looking down at it, my clock faces here, this is 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. I want it about 1 o'clock so that I can get this thing cranked down pretty good. So unthread it from the barrel and I'm going to apply rock set onto the barrel threads. Now, when it comes to rock set, less is more. You don't need to goop a crap ton of rock set onto it. Just a tiny amount onto the threads will do, and that's again why I would recommend a little bit of a toothpick so that when you're fishing this stuff out, you're just putting a tiny amount on the thread. So I'm gonna do that real quick. I'm actually just gonna dab my own toothpick into this, and I am just gonna put a tiny amount along the threads. I mean tiny. This is barely wet. It's not going across the whole thing. It's not dripping all the way across everything. And I'm going to re-thread the compensator back onto this barrel. Now, we have our 1 o'clock angle in relation to our front sight post. I'm gonna put the entire Wicked Compensator into the soft jaw. So now we have the Wicked Compensator locked into the soft jaws of the vise. We got the rock set on it. We have the correct shim stack in place. And I'm going to put this 5/8 wrench onto the back of the locking block here, and I'm going to turn it counterclockwise as I'm looking down the barrel from the locking block so that I can align the wrench and the compensator to the slide at that 12 o'clock position. So I'm just gonna crank it into position there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna visually eyeball it. That's actually exactly where it needs to be. So, didn't take a lot, about 20 degrees of motion. And now that is locked into place. What I'm gonna be looking at here is this center line matched up with the front sight post? Is there, you know, equal spacing on the right and left? I'm even gonna check the gap here for equal light on both sides. And honestly, that's pretty much nailed. That is the actual installation of the compensator to the barrel. Now, before you go out and shoot this, I like to let my rock set sit for 24 hours to completely dry and form a good seal. It's kind of like glass when you see it, if you've ever broken a rock set seal off of one of your muzzle devices, but I like to give it 24 hours before I actually introduce it to the blast and concussion of an actual live round. So slide assembly is done. We can set that aside. And our next project will be working on the recoil assembly. So let's get that going. Now this is the least fun part of the Wicked Compensator install. So a couple things I want you to notice here. The factory recoil spring is painted red, so it's pretty easy to identify visually, especially compared to the aftermarket or the custom lightened recoil stainless version that I've got. So red would be factory, the stainless one is what we're going to install. I want you to notice how the buffer that rides along the outside of the recoil guide rod sits. The little hard plastic part is at the front of the slide. So when we are reinstalling it, just remember this orientation. So I'm gonna set the new recoil spring aside. And what we're going to do, and the goal of this is we're trying to depress this entire recoil assembly to the point where I can get my pliers on here to squeeze the end of this so that it collapses just enough to allow this washer to come off and then the entire spring assembly. And this is where the baggie comes into play. The reason I do it in here is because the very first time I actually did this, I got it off really, really quickly. And then it shot across my garage and it took me, no kidding, probably 3.5 hours to find. I'm just taking this entire thing and I'm pulling it down. Really hard to do on camera, so I apologize. Got part of it. Yep, there she goes. So you really only need to get it kind of at an angle. As soon as one side slips off, the washer usually, you know, flies across the room, but there it is. So you'll also notice on the washer wear marks from it sliding back and forth. Make sure that that's the side that you continue to use. I'm removing the entire thing off the guide rod, taking this spring, and I'm setting it aside along with our baggie because we won't need it again. This is the orientation. We've got guide rod, we've got new spring, and again, it does not matter which direction this goes in. They're machined flats, just like the factory one. So it can go either way. So we're installing the spring onto the guide rod assembly. Then we're installing the buffer over the spring. Remember the plastic part towards the front. And now we're going to use our tool. And this is pretty cool. It's big enough so that the guide rod will pass through, but it's large enough to allow the washer to sit in there. So I'm just gonna install the washer into the bottom of the tool, and then I'm gonna take the entire thing, and I'm just going to do that. As soon as it pops through, we're done. Finished. I'm going to grab the entire slide assembly, and I'm going to install the front part into the pocket, and the back into the locking block. And I'm going to install the slide back onto the entire frame assembly. I'm going to lock it all the way to the rear. I'm going to push this in when it aligns with the little notch in the slide. And that's it. We have completed the Wicked Compensator installation. And that's really as simple as it goes.
Now that the Wicked Compensator is installed on the pistol, you've waited 24 hours for the rock set to dry and have a really good bond, you're ready to take it out for its initial break-in. Now before you do so, because you cleaned the pistol, I would highly recommend lubricating the pistol very thoroughly, where the slide rides on the frame, where the locking block meets the slide, even taking out the magazine spring and lubricating the front wall where the nose of the rounds line up inside of the magazine, lightly oil that. It makes the rounds feed better, but with that lightened recoil spring on it, the wetter it is and the more lubricated the magazine and all of the internal parts are, the better it runs.
To make a clone correct wick stick, you would need a P30L in 9mm. To make it 100% clone correct, you would need a P30L SD so that the serial number on the barrel matches the one on the frame. Nitpicking, but that's the way that they did it for their movie. It needs to be a version 3, which is the double action, single action with the decocker at the back. Factory 15 round magazines, and then on John Wick's particular one, he used a medium backstrap and small side inserts, and that's it. Nothing else was terribly crazy about John Wick's pistol other than this particular compensator and threaded barrel.
Now to really complete your LARP, you're going to need a holster. The one I'm currently using is from a company called Odin. This is a out of the waistband holster. The nice thing about the Wicked Compensator is that the Wicked Compensator itself does not change the profile of the actual gun in any way, shape, or form. If the holster can have the firearm pass through it, compensator will fit just fine. Any open bottom holster will work with the Wicked Compensator. That's the nice part about it being so monolithic to the slide and to the frame. It doesn't change the profile, only the length. You're probably not going to be appendix carrying this, and in fact, a little warning. With the reduced weight recoil spring and the gigantic weight and compensator hanging off the front of this, this gun will actually be less reliable than it is from the factory when it is using a factory recoil spring and no compensator. So, with that in mind, this gun can have or will be more prone to failure, as far as failure to feed, failure to extract, failure to fire, stove piping, and the less lubrication it has, the more prone it becomes to doing so. So I would not ever, ever, ever recommend taking a Wicked Compensator equipped gun and using it as a home defense pistol, a personal defense pistol like your CCW, and I wouldn't really even use it as a competition gun because it can cause failures. Again, very, very, very light recoil spring in the slide. Works great for the compensator, but it doesn't work great for everything. So with that in mind, please, please, please only use this as a fun LARPing range toy. Don't use it for anything that you depend on for your reputation in competitions or for your life or your loved ones' lives or the lives of the citizens around you, because I don't want that to be the reason that you weren't accurate or that you weren't having a good day, because it's not made to be anything other than a Hollywood look-alike prop. Now, it's a functional prop because it is on an actual firearm and it does function as an actual compensator, but it was made solely for the intention of looking like a on-screen correct movie John Wick gun and nothing more. I don't claim that it gives me a 33% reduction in felt recoil or faster follow-up shots or anything like that. That's not what it's for. It's literally just to look like John Wick's gun. And it does that exceedingly well. So keep that in mind should you decide to purchase one. So, you've had your Wicked Compensator on for a few thousand rounds, and you would like to remove it for deep cleaning of the gun. Totally, totally not a problem. Just like the installation, I want to make sure that this handgun is unloaded, so I'm going to lock the slide to the rear. I'm going to take out the magazine. I'm going to inspect and put a pinky in there. I'm going to check down the magwell. I'm going to look at the bolt face, and I'm just going to completely check that this thing is completely unloaded. Then we are going to, again, lock the slide to the rear. I'm going to push out the slide release assembly until I can see that red band.
I'm going to remove the frame. I'm going to set that aside. I'm going to remove the recoil assembly. I'm going to set that aside. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the entire assembly like this, and I'm going to stick the barrel out as far as I possibly can from the slide, and I'm going to let this compensator and barrel assembly soak in boiling hot water in my kitchen. Now this is a very fun home experience. If you want to watch your wife go absolutely berserk, bring firearm parts into the kitchen. So what we're doing right now is we are boiling a pot of water so that we can break the seal on the rock set on this particular Wicked Compensator. This is the original prototype. It's been on there for a very long time with quite a few rounds through it, and it's held very well. But what we're going to do, we're going to soak this bad boy in water once this reaches boiling temperature, and then we're going to go right back out into the garage. So here's what we want. Nice, boiling, hot water. And we're just going to set that bad boy in there so that the threads are covered and the whole part is covered. Oops. We're just going to leave that in there for about, I don't know, a minute, 2 minutes. Literally just got this bad boy out of that hot boiling water. And I'm going to put this into the vise. And I'm going to take my 5/8 wrench. And I'm going to go clockwise while looking at it this time. And boom, look how quick and easy that came apart. Whew, this sucker is hot. Good to go. And the neat part about this is the shim stack will typically stay in the back of this. So whatever you need to do, you don't need to re-shim it. You just need to clean up the threads a little bit, apply more rock set. But now you can take the barrel out of the assembly. You can clean it, do whatever you need to do. In John Wick, he used a P30L 9mm with a custom threaded on compensator. Now in the movie, the ports were not open. It didn't actually function. It was Hollywood BS, but it looked great. It's just one of those iconic movie guns that the moment you saw, you're like, what is that and why can't I find one? When I sought out to create this compensator, there were a lot of obstacles I had to overcome to make it not only screen accurate, but actually functional. I didn't see the point in making it like the on-screen compensator because that compensator was fake. It didn't actually have open ports. It did not compensate for recoil and was really just an aesthetic add-on to make the gun look a little more beefy and more hero gun-like, similar to like RoboCop. Gigantic, massive gun that really served no purpose other than to look more massive on screen, have more persona, and that's really what the creators of the John Wick P30L decided to do for that particular movie. In fact, this is a very good, accurate representation of what the compensator from the movie looked like. You'll notice that the ports are evenly spaced across the top, symmetrical, but you might also notice that they are not open. You can't actually have any gases vented out the front of it. It still has the nozzle on the front, just like the movie one did. And the hole in the front, just like the movie one did, with the Picatinny rail on the bottom. And that's a pretty good representation of the on-screen compensator.
Some of the interesting design features about the Wicked Compensator are that it's as close to the movie compensator as humanly possible, save for two really distinct things. Number one being that the porting on the actual compensator in the movie was fake. This one is real. They are open. This is functional. You will see flames coming out of the top of this when you fire it.
The actual Wicked Compensator, a little bit different. Not by a lot, but just enough. You'll notice that my ports are not symmetrically spaced because the threaded barrel sticks so far out of the slide that it actually would have impeded and blocked the port on the very first section here. The barrel actually sits right up into that point. So I shifted all of the ports forward and then I opened them and made them just a little bit smaller so that they would actually vent gas out of the front of this particular compensator and make it functional.
The Picatinny rail, you will notice, is actually not exactly in line with the frame. That was done intentionally. The movie compensator tapers ever so slightly at the top and at the bottom so that it doesn't look so blocky. Our compensator follows that same taper, but we made our 1913 Picatinny rail out of spec and not in line with the frame on purpose, so that somebody can't accidentally hurt themselves or the gun by mounting a light to it or bridging it, so that the slide and the action wouldn't work and causing injury or death to themselves. So we basically made that foolproof so that there's no possible way that anyone can mount anything on it. Now, to get to this stage and why it took 4 years, one, it happened in the middle of COVID. In fact, I started this project at the end of 2018, and into 2019 is when we started doing a lot of the CAD and the design work. So to get to that point, I had to take an actual P30L and I had to send it off to a company that does 3D laser scans. And we took an actual P30, because I did find quite a few models online that were CAD ready that were of a P30L. The problem is they were likenesses. They were drawn by not using an actual firearm. They were made to look as close to the firearm as humanly possible, but when you'd actually scale it one-to-one against an actual firearm, there were lots of discrepancies. So I didn't want to start with a likeness model of a P30L. I wanted an actual firearm correct of a P30L. So we laser scanned the entire firearm assembly. We then imported that particular gun into CAD, and then we used an extruding method in CAD to make sure that the frame and the slide of the P30L matched what we designed for the compensator. So you'll notice that all of the lines on the compensator and the slide match exactly. There is no surface on this compensator that is not an exact replica of what the HK factory slide does. This is as monolithic as you could possibly become. And so we designed it to be that particular way, just like the original one on the movie. We had to do quite a few different prints and tests and things. We found that the recoil spring was much too heavy to get it to cycle reliably, so we had to create our own recoil spring assembly. We had to adjust porting sizes. We had them very large at first, but they were bleeding off so much gas and they were compensating so well that it actually was having failures to eject. It would sometimes stovepipe, failures to feed. The compensator was a little too effective, so we had to reduce the port sizes. Those required additional times and machining and retesting, etc., etc., etc. So because I am not in the industry of manufacturing firearms, I had to enlist a lot of help from a lot of different people across the country. I hired designers, I hired engineers, I handled hired gunsmiths, I hired machine shops. There's a lot of people that went into making this particular product a reality. We did do quite a bit of lightening on the back. There are pockets, there are little drilled holes in the back of this thing. It's kind of hard to see because of the lighting in here, but this is an incredibly lightweight piece of aluminum. If you are interested in getting your own Wicked Compensator for your HK P30L, go ahead and go to our website at wickedcompensator.com. Lots more information on the product, how we made it, how it was designed, how the R&D went, all of that fun stuff. If you guys are into that kind of stuff, website has more. That's it for today's video. If you liked it, give it a like. If you didn't, a dislike. Subscribe for more content, and I'll see you guys in the next one.